C5, we determined where that engine ought to go. They were afraid those engines were so big that they were gonna have such an interference that it would, actually the plane wouldn't fly, you know. But, of course, we ran them in various positions up and down and forward and back, and we determined where the engine ought to be on the C5, so that was a point. Mm-hmm. And
was that the most satisfying accomplishment you had?
Well, no. They were running some tests out on the field, smoke tests, the vortex, and of course, the engine installation had an effect on the wingtip vortex and the induced drag of their airplane. Mm-hmm. And of course, the problem though is when you put the engine on, you lost lift. And even though you were reducing some induced drag. But I asked the Whitaker, I said, I'd like to see those guys with what they're doing with that vortex smoke. I went out there and I realized that the vortex doesn't move. You know, they call it a trailing vortex. But it doesn't, it stands still. The airplane flies away. And I went back and told Whitcomb that, you know. He wasn't too sure about that. But the next day he came and he said, you're right. He said, find a facility that you can test that. And we started working on that towing tank, and we turned it into a vortex facilitation. And that was what I thought was the best thing. And we determined in that facility how to get rid of the vortex. And we determined that it was the axial flow going right down the middle of the vortex, which was energizing the vortex. Because it was standing still, and this flow was going by and just giving energy as it did. And that's why it persists so long. It let them stay up there 10 minutes, you know. But that was really the